We're going to go over auto-numbering in Excel. I created a short about it a little earlier, but I think it'd be a good idea to go into a little bit more detail. And the formula I enjoy using is the row formula. So that's equals, row, open paren, close paren, minus one. And then you double click on the bottom right-hand corner of the cell to populate the entire column. So this formula, what it's doing is checking which row it's on, in this case two, and then subtracting one. And it's doing that throughout. As you can see, every cell is identical. So 8 minus 1 is 7. What I like about this formula, if you sort by any other column, let's say by record number, you'll notice the A column is left alone. Now it is included in the sort, but since the formula is identical in each cell, the product is always going to be the same, even though it's technically being sorted with the rest of the table. Now let's really drive this home. We're going to delete this again. Let's say you wanted to start the numbering on row 3. That would be equal sign, row, open paren, close paren, minus 2. And then double click again on the bottom right hand corner to fill the whole column. So what the formula is doing now is subtracting by 2. So 3 minus 2 is 1, 4 minus 2 is 2. You just have to make sure that the first instance of the formula equals to 1. This is useful if your header takes up two rows. Now, another way to auto number a column is to enter a manual 1. Just type in 1 in this cell and then equal sign, click on the cell above it, which is the one, and then add one, and then hit enter. And then double click again, bottom right-hand corner to fill the column. So this achieves the same goal, except it's not my favorite because if you sort by any other column, it's going to destroy column A. Because as you can see, each cell is not identical, so it's going to produce a different product. So let's sort by this one. As you can see, it just doesn't work. It's referencing A1 now, and A1 is not a number. Now, if you insist on using this method, there is a way around the problem. First, we're going to turn off the filters, and then we're going to filter only the columns that you want sorted, so B and C. Now let's sort and see what happens. So you notice A remained the same because it's no longer part of the filter. And another way of working around it, turn off filter again, and we'll filter every column, including A. Select A, copy it, Control C, go to home, pull down paste, click on paste special, and then click on values, and then click OK. When you paste special value, it converts the formulas into text. So now this is straight text. This can be useful as well, especially if you want that number to be associated with the row at all times, even when it's sorted. So that's actually useful. So now let's sort by record number. As you can see, the numbers sorted along with the rest of the row. If you found this video helpful, please hit like and comment below if you have any questions. If you're working on a project that's similar to this and you needed a little help, you know, comment below and I will try and get back to you later that night. I am Central Time. And hit subscribe. That really helps the channel out. Thank you and have a good day.